So I'm sitting here with Jacob Maelk Toft-Andersen from North. I would like to know, what is the reason why have you chosen this name?
We've chosen North because we are the North. It represents us really well. Scandinavia, obviously regarded as the North, and it's important for us not to just be Denmark, not just be Copenhagen, but represent an entire region that eventually will take over the rest of the world.
What does it mean for you that a known brand and a household brand in the Scandinavian region and even in Europe, like FC Copenhagen, is going in and supporting this one?
I mean, it means the world, honestly. I think FC Copenhagen is probably the best Scandinavian football team. And for them to then acknowledge, as a Dane myself, for them to acknowledge esport and not only acknowledge it, but fully invest into it in the biggest scale possible, makes this the most interesting project for me to be a part of.
You've already talked about in the press conference about wanting to add us, you know, other games, and you already acknowledged that you weren't looking into League of Legends because of the business model. What other games will you be pursuing?
So at the offset, without making any promises, we're definitely looking into Dota 2. We believe there's this trifecta of major esports titles at present time, one being Counter-Strike, the other being League of Legends, and then there's Dota 2. So with having said that, League of Legends is not on our radar right now, Dota 2 obviously is. And aside from that, at some point we'd like to develop FIFA as an esport as well. We feel it has a lot of potential. It's on the rise. EA is finally paying it a lot of attention, and the Danish market has a lot of good players. We have two world champions, and we hope to develop more of those, hopefully under the North name.
So you're going to be you're coming into an esports world. You yourself has been, you know, a professional esports player. You've been to the international 2 times. You've owned your own team. You helped Schalke build that team. What do you feel that you can do better or differently with North?
I've learned a lot from all of those things, as like successes as well as failures. And I think it's fair to say that all of those things had both successes and failures. So with all that in mind and all that experience behind me, I feel like I have the necessary skill set to justify my position in a major organization, a major project like this one. And in all honesty, I don't feel like there's a better candidate in the Danish market to help North and FC Copenhagen and Nordic Film to achieve their goals.
Do you feel that your background as a professional player is helping this along, you know, if you compare yourself to other people in this industry?
Oh yeah, definitely. I think it's important for people in similar positions to mine to understand what it is, what it feels like to be a player, what kind of hopes and dreams they have, obviously, but also what concerns they have. And a lot of the time, what we've seen in esports organizations over the years is that they don't really neither respect the player or understand their needs fully. And it often creates a disconnect between organization and player. So instead of working together, they almost seem to be fighting. We've seen that a lot in recent time as well. And I think that's one of the things that former players have an edge in comparison to those who are not.
You've spoken a little bit about the ambition level of North. Can you try and develop that thought to us?
So it's important for us not to just look at the Danish or the Scandinavian market, but look at it globally. We want to be the world leaders. We want to achieve greatness throughout all continents. We're not a Danish team. We're not a Scandinavian team. We're a world-class team, and we want to just be the best.